on with our process costing series, and in this video, we're going to continue on with the steps used in process costing. So now that we have accounted for our units and computed equivalent units, we can now summarize the total cost to account for. So in this slide, you can see the shaping department costs that were incurred while working on those 50,000 masks that we accounted for in an earlier video. We have our beginning work in process cost, our direct materials cost, our conversion cost, and our total cost that we need to account for, $208,000. And we've divided that out between materials and conversion in our spreadsheet. So our total cost that we need to account for being the $208,000. So now if we use that $208,000 and pull it apart to the $140,000 for direct materials that we need to account for, the $68,000 in conversion cost that we need to account for, pulling from that spreadsheet, taking the cost and dividing it by the total equivalent units that we computed in step two, 50,000 equivalent units as to direct materials and 42,500 equivalent units as to conversion cost, we get a cost per equivalent unit for materials of $2.80 and for conversion of $1.60. Once we have computed our cost per equivalent unit, we can use this cost to assign total cost to units that are completed and transferred out, as well as cost in our ending work in process. So here we have our equivalent units as to materials and conversion that were transferred out, which was the 40,000 units, multiplied times the cost per unit that we just calculated in step four, gives us the cost assigned to the units that were completed and transferred out per direct materials of $112,000, per conversion of $64,000. Now, the ending work in process had 10,000 equivalent units as to materials, multiplied by the 280 gives us $28,000 assigned to units in ending work in process per materials. For conversion, only 25% of them were complete as to conversion, so 2,500 equivalent units as to conversion times the $1.60 per equivalent unit gives us $4,000 assigned to work in process as of conversion cost, giving us total cost accounted for of $208,000. So to wrap up, let's try an example. Here we have Tristan Company. They produce its product using a single production process. For the month of August, the company determined its cost per equivalent unit to be as follows. So we've already computed our cost per equivalent unit for materials of $4.20, for conversion to be $2.75. During the month, Tristan completed and transferred out 410,000 units to finished goods inventory. At month end, 86,000 partially completed units remained in ending work in process. These partially completed units were equal to 69,000 equivalent units of direct materials and 50,000 equivalent units of conversion cost. So we need first to determine the total cost that should be assigned to the following: units completed and transferred out, units in ending work in process inventory. Then we should find out what was the total cost to account for, and then what was Tristan's average cost of making one unit of product. So push pause on your player and attempt this problem. So the first thing we want to do is determine the cost that should be assigned to the units completed and transferred out. So the units that were completed and transferred out was 410,000 units that were transferred to finished goods. Well, if the average cost of a unit is $4.20 per materials and $2.75 per conversion, we would take the total cost per unit, multiply that times the units completed, and we find that the total cost assigned to the units computed and transferred out, completed and transferred out, is $2,849,500. To compute the total cost that should be assigned to the units in ending work in process, well, we know that we have 86,000 partially completed units in ending work in process. Of those partially completed units, 69,000 are equivalent as to direct materials and 50,000 equivalent as to conversion. So to find our total cost assigned to this ending inventory, we would take the direct material cost of $4.20 times the equivalent units completed as two materials plus the $2.75 our cost per equivalent unit as two conversion cost. Multiply that times the equivalent units completed as two conversion cost, and that gives us our total cost of ending work in process to be $427,300. Therefore, the total cost that we have accounted for is the total cost of units completed and transferred out plus the total cost of ending work in process inventory, which is $3,276,800. Therefore, Tristan's average cost of making one unit of product is the cost per equivalent unit for materials plus the cost per equivalent unit of conversion cost, giving us $6.95.